1854 was when Lester Howe's eldest daughter got married, and she was the first one to get married in the cave. But she didn't get married in this spot. She got married in a spot called the Bridal Chamber, which was a lot closer to the entrance. It's no longer around, but that's actually where the stone quarry is. So it was one of the sections the quarry blew up back in the early 1900s. When the cave reopened in 1929, this is where we've been having the weddings ever since. The heart that you see here is a piece of calcite that's cut into the shape of a heart, so that is not the natural shape of this calcite that you're looking at right here. It's about 5 to 6 inches thick with a light bulb underneath it causing the heart to glow. The bride and the groom would stand on the heart. The minister would be where I am or just in front of the heart with the wedding party kind of like in a half circle. And since 1929, we have had exactly 686 weddings in this cave. I'm gonna wait right here for everybody.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Echo.
No, that happened naturally.
I think
you guys are right with this camera.
It's a winding tunnel.
Jared,
watch out. Right here is the highest point of the winding way. So it's about 100. It's about 4 feet high right here.
Don't look up here. This is the highest point. This is the highest point.
That's like 12 feet.
At least.
It's really good. Sharp cheddar and sharp sometimes.